One of the biggest determining factors in a successful design is proportion. It's the fundamental building block. Now, if we start with a square and just divide it up into evenly sized pieces, it can feel a little bit static. It's challenging to arrange these similarly sized shapes in an interesting way. You're just going to end up with a bunch of Tetris pieces, basically, and there's just really not a whole lot going on. Now, if you take that same square and divide each piece into proportionally smaller thirds, you suddenly have much more interesting designs. This breaking up into thirds is based on the golden ratio. I'm not going to get into the golden ratio really at all in this video, but basically, it's a proportion that's very commonly found in nature, and it's very pleasing to the eye. So a lot of times, industrial designers are given a specific internal layout for components. Other times, they have really strict ergonomic constraints that dictate the shape of the object that you're designing. Under these circumstances, it can be a little bit more challenging to come up with a visually balanced shape, but you can still break the form up using varying materials or placing parting lines in specific areas, having color breaks and things like that. One thing I want to mention is that this isn't a rule that you have to follow for all of your designs. It's just a starting point. There are times when other approaches might make more sense. It just depends on the project and your just general design sensibilities. And it doesn't even need to be perfectly broken up into thirds. What's more important is that there's a general size hierarchy going from the big silhouettes down to the small details. So let's look at some examples of product designs that do this. So this is a design for Braun by Dieter Rams, and it feels balanced because of this very clear hierarchy in proportion. Now, this stuff doesn't need to be restricted to blocky or geometric objects. The same principles still apply for more organic forms. So, for example, this Herman Miller sail chair designed by Fuse Project uses similar principles. The general volume of each shape is nicely divided up into big, medium, and small. So why does this work? Basically, humans love visual organization, and by having these different sized pieces, it creates a hierarchy. It shows you where you need to look first, second, and third. The big objects grab more attention and are therefore viewed as more important. The middle-sized objects break up the form, and the small details create that little bit of extra visual interest. You can use these techniques to create little visual tricks as well. So if you want to make an object appear thinner, you can break the shape up into different pieces, like with chamfers, for example. If you want it to appear sturdier or stronger, you can make it all one uniform piece, or you can make it trapezoidally shaped, so it just feels a little bit more grounded, basically. So I hope this was helpful. As always, feel free to leave your feedback in the comments. There are many ways to communicate things purely through form hierarchy, so I'll probably do more videos like this. As always, feel free to leave a like and subscribe.